What's up, YouTube? We're out on Land's End in San Francisco. So I haven't posted in a while. We've been moving to a new place. So for the past 2 weeks, we've been slowly moving boxes. We lost our couch because it couldn't fit through the front door of our new place. Jax has been settling in and we're finally getting used to the new area. So, but we're here on Land's End this morning. It's on the
Valentine's Day,
northern point of San Francisco. Kind of a coastal trail. It's really cool. We've been here, I think, once before in the past. I've done this trail run here before when training for a marathon last year, where I got injured. But it's a great place. Wide paths. There's definitely some elevation, but it's a good training spot.
Up in the morning with a smile on my face. What a wonderful feeling. Headed to the doctor with a smile on my face. Please believe that I've been waiting half a lifetime to see my name on that card. Yeah, we struggle so hard. Police, they wanna lock us up, maybe just a week ago, not today, Don't mind standing in the line. Now it's just about to nick a time till I can ease my mind. Burn it legally. Feels so good to say I got my license to smoke. Yeah, I got my license to smoke. Oh, I got my license to smoke. Yeah, I got my license to smoke. Roll it up and let it pass it to my people. They gotta worry about nobody cause I'm legal.
So something that is actually a really great purchase is a camel pack. So this is a Nathan camel pack, a small pack. I think it's a couple liters at most. Great if you're doing long trail runs, but also it's a great way to carry water for yourself and your dog. Jax, come here. It took Jax a little bit of time to understand how to drink out of this, out of the tube, but basically, I just point the spout down and I'd release the pressure and it would shoot out water, and Jax has learned how to basically drink from the spout. And it's been a really great way, so we don't have to carry around a bowl or some other water bottle / bowl contraption. We've just used this pack. It's been an easy way to carry water and feed Jax water when he needs it.
Sponsored by Billabong. Surf a girl type of girl I like to fill up on. In the water, really want to rock a boat like a hurricane in a perfect storm, Lord. Ask her where she on her way to. Said, holla, Eva. Say she love the North Shore. Bikini top, black Scots, and then board shorts. Paddle out.
Something we've been training with, or training Jax for, or actually really training ourselves, is to not let other people give Jax treats. And the reason is, recently, Jax is his personality, he's really friendly, so, and we like that, you know, if he goes up to other people and says hi. But recently it's been going up to other people, saying hi, and then kind of jumping at their fanny pack or anything they're holding, because he's starting to associate those things with treats. And he's been used to other people, other dog owners giving him treats, so he's been a little bit too too confident in that area. So, and we've actually gotten chastised by a couple people in off-leash spots, so, you know, we're not, we won't talk about those people, but about Jack's kind of approaching them, and he's not even jumping on them. But regardless, it's still a reminder that, hey, if we can kind of curb that habit, and if Jax goes up to people and says hi, great, that's totally fine with us, but we don't want him starting to jump and follow other people, because of course it can be a little bit annoying. So it does feel kind of weird, right, when people ask if you can feed your dog, and you're like, no, don't feed your dog, or don't feed our dog. Maybe it's not weird. I just feel like I'm being a little, I feel like I sound too strict, but you know, who cares, right? But I think we've seen some positive results from doing that. And just letting him know that, you know, if he wants food or treats, then, you know, he can come to us, but don't go to other people. And that's why I said it's really training us more than training Jax to say no. And the best thing is when other owners ask us if it's okay to feed Jax treats before they actually do it. Some people don't, and they just feed Jax, and I hate that. Of course, there's no ill intention there, but for other new owners out there, if you do have treats, before you give to other dogs, just ask the owner, because you don't know what their training goals are, their current training status is. So something we learned, you know, we're trying to improve in a lot of aspects of being dog owners too. Unrelated to Jax and dog training, but something I figured I'd try to talk about here too is with the pandemic, and just the difference in working styles and communication with everyone on some messaging app or email or video calls. The culture has shifted a lot, and there are some obvious changes. For example, working from home and things you can physically aware of, but there's also changes that happen that creep up on you and affect you in different ways. Something I've been feeling last couple weeks is kind of stagnant at work and in my personal life, and somewhat of a lack of motivation recently. And it's nothing to do with, you know, the people at work or the people in my personal relationships. But I was just trying to figure it out, and it was very uncharacteristic of me to feel that way for such a long time, and just trying to understand what it was, you know, if there's something obvious that's affecting me, or... But I talked to some people, some mentors in my life, and one of their tips was to be open to change. And continue to question things, continue to be critical. But a good mentor told me there's two different paths to criticism. So criticism is healthy, but if it turns into judgment, it can become a toxic mentality. But if you turn into curiosity, it can be a very healthy state of mind that encourages growth, encourages the right questions. The way you communicate, if you're curious, comes out better if you're communicating in a judgmental way too. So I've been kind of switching that mindset, and it has helped a lot. I've been more open to exploring new ways to improve my technical craft at work, but also being open to exploring new things at work. And yeah, so sometimes it's just like a shift of mentality, and you don't know what that shift is until someone you know and trusts and cares about you mentions. Sometimes a change doesn't have to be drastic. It's not like you have to change your lifestyle or do something physically different, but just that switch of like, okay, be open to change, and be curious. Just those two words and phrases have really unblocked me recently. So yeah, I just want to share that random event, feeling I've been dealing with recently. How's everyone doing, you know, at home and in the pandemic? I hope everyone's safe, healthy. Have you felt blocked recently, whether it's at work or in some other way, right? It doesn't have to be work. And if so, how do you unblock yourself?
Stop.